standing on the bridge, I'm waiting in the dark. I thought that you'd be here by now. There's nothing but the rain, no footsteps on the ground. I'm listening, but there's no sound. Isn't anyone trying to find me? Won't somebody come take me home? It's that damn cold night, and trying to figure out.
Paws in the City does whatever it can to save the animals of Dallas, but nothing can be done without the generosity of our donors. When Prince was brought to a vet, he had been brutally abused and had life-threatening injuries to his internal organs. Expensive surgery was needed. Paws in the City stepped in and paid for the surgery after his owners left him at the vet to die. Paws in the City saved 6 dogs from the city shelter who would not make their adoption program due to treatable ailments. 3-month-old Pirate needed eye surgery. Truman had a hernia, and Cookie, Percy, Parker, and Hudson all had heartworm. As a no-kill organization, Paws in the City is dedicated to finding homes for all of our animals. Not having a shelter, Paws utilizes foster homes and boarding facilities. Dogs unable to be placed in foster or adoptive homes due to behavioral issues are trained. And thanks to our wonderful trainer, Juan, our track record is 100%. Winnie was rescued from a city shelter on her last day and put into boarding. She was very dominant and not getting along with other dogs. She was in dire need of training.
The unique thing about Paws in the City is that in addition to providing for her physical needs, for the dog's physical needs, we've partnered in order to provide them with their psychological needs as well.
Logan was found emaciated. He was so gentle that the city shelter actually begged us to rescue him. We found he was severely infected with heartworms. Although his condition was grim, the loving nature of this dog made us want to save him. Like Logan, many dogs at the city shelter are considered unadoptable due to heartworms. The city shelters cannot treat heartworms. Unless a rescue group takes these dogs, they are euthanized. Although costly, heartworms are treatable most of the time. Spay or neutering is a vital component to reducing the pet overpopulation problem. Spring is kitten and puppy season, and sadly, many puppies and kittens do not survive at a city shelter. Having no immune system, they are often subject to disease. When Paws in the City takes them into his foster care, we spay or neuter every animal in our program. Realizing Paws in the City cannot save all the homeless dogs and cats, we created our guest dog and cat program. If someone needs to rehome their pet and are willing to keep the pet until a home can be found, we will post the animal on our website and they can bring the pet to our adoption events. Paws in the City will assist with processing adoption applications and home checks. The same service is offered to someone who finds a stray or an animal in an abusive situation and is willing to foster the dog or cat. Rue is a good example. Rue was found as a stray and had been used as bait to train fighting dogs and cast to the side of the road when she was no longer useful. All she could do was lay there helpless, exposed to the outside elements as a result of her 2 paralyzed front legs. Just as animal control was coming to get Rue, the neighbors decided to join together to save her. Rue was covered with abrasions, bite scars, and her teeth were filed down, a common practice with bait dogs. The neighbors needed help and turned to the guest dog program of Paws in the City. In today's economic environment, dogs and cats are dumped at city shelters all over the Metroplex, now more than ever before. Whether due to financial setbacks or lack of housing that permits pets, people are abandoning their pets. We can save more of these animals from the shelter if we have donations for vet services and foster homes. We could not save as many animals as we do without the dedication of our foster parents providing love, attention, shelter, and exercise. If you cannot donate, consider fostering. Paws in the City felt this cuddly ball of fur deserved another chance at life and funded several surgeries for Prince. He is fully recovered and living in a loving new home. Hudson never really got sick and was adopted by his foster mom. Parker has found his forever home. Percy recovered, but is still awaiting his forever home. Cookie was adopted by her foster dad. Sadly, we lost Truman and Pirate to distemper. Winnie worked with our trainer Juan, and we are happy to report that she will have a home for life. As with Winnie, Juan has worked with other dogs that had behavioral issues. All are now happily living in a foster or forever home. With Juan's help, No Paws Dog will be in a kennel environment for very long. Paws in the City was ready to treat Logan for his heartworms, but he was too weak to survive. Sadly, there was nothing we could do to save Logan. However, all these dogs were saved from city shelters and treated for heartworms. Many organizations will not rescue dogs who need heartworm treatment, but Paws gives these dogs a second chance. Many are purebreds, small and large, and very adoptable once they are healthy. Our puppies and kittens continue to grow and are looking for homes after being neutered. The citizens of Dallas are very grateful for our guest dog and cat program. Through this program, we are able to help the community even when our foster program is full. Rue is healthy now, but the vet holds only slight hope for her front legs to recover. However, Rue, showing her resiliency, taught herself to walk, run, and climb stairs on her two back legs like a kangaroo. Her inspirational character and great kindness after all she has been through is amazing. Through Paws in the City's guest dog program, her ultimate permanent home will be found. You can make a difference, even just for one animal. Please donate and save a life. I'm Preston Pearson, and we can stop the killing.